I'm still excited from over the weekend. So, woo. I'm still super excited. Yesterday, listen, hold on, let me back up. God say to those that are on the podcast and for those that are on Facebook Live, God say, welcome to God say. If this is your first time listening or you haven't been over here in a while, God say, thank you the Lord for waking us up this morning. This morning, starting us on our way. There wasn't drama to us. He didn't have to do it, but I'm glad that he did. He woke you up this morning. I'm glad for all the things that he has done prior to today. I'm grateful that he's given us a brand new day that was not promised to us, that he didn't recycle yesterday and give it back to us today. He's given us a brand new day. Any problems, issues, situations, whatever we have done in the past, he's given us today to correct it, to fix it, to make it better, to get our lives in order, to get our lives right. Too much happening around here for us not to have our lives in order. When I tell you the excitement I have on, even though I'm so tired, my body is tired, I'm tired, I'm exhausted, let me say that. I'm exhausted. But when it comes down to listen to this song, it's still on. Jun know he needs this song. Pastor Key, y'all don't know. Pastor Key did this song. Listen, when I tell you, yesterday, I posted the videos from yesterday for first service and second service, and I'm exhausted, but hey, it was all worth it when you exhausted because of what you've done when it come down. The bishop said, and he always tell us, you're supposed to be tired when you go home, when you leave church. You're supposed to be tired because you don't gave God your, but you don't even know. They might shut us down. They might shut down the world and this mortal law, whatever. And this may be your last time giving God the praise. Let me do my best. I know folks probably was looking at me crazy like, is something wrong with her? It absolutely is. But it's for Jesus, though. I'm routed when it comes to Jesus. Listen, if y'all did not see the video, look, my voice seemed like it's trying to do something. If you did not come yesterday to either service, you were not in the listen. Yesterday evening, though, Bishop Smith didn't even get a chance to preach. We was trying to do offering. Listen, I'm sorry. No, I don't apologize for the kind of craziness that we love to. Pastor Roosevelt, listen, if you still on here, sir, y'all don't just came. Listen, the love, the absolutely amazingness. The services that was, listen, I posted them on my page. Y'all go to my page and you will see the services on there. Might be a few things posted before then. If not, it's on the New Freeman Chapel Missionary Baptist Church page. Please go back and watch that. Please go back. And it was just nothing like being in the building. It was so much happening in that service. It was ridiculous. Celebrate. When you talk about celebrating, that's a celebration. That is a celebration. We were celebrating 5 years of our church anniversary. It's been a long struggle. Not saying still not going to be. Still not. I'm not saying that. But I'm saying it's been a long, long little way. Pretty good piece of ups and downs. Some goods and some bads, some trials and tribulations, but now we have a testimony and we can celebrate. Even though you know where, you know, 5 years, you don't got over that 5 years. You know, so what they say, when you get married, you get over that 5-year hump, you can make it, you can do it. So we over that 5-year hump now, and God has just been doing some amazing things. He still got some better things in store. He got some awesomeness that's gonna be even greater than before. But yesterday, yo, when I tell y'all, I don't even understand. God just really showed up and showed out on yesterday, and I am happy. So that excitement that I, like I said, I'm still tired. I'm exhausted. But at the same time, though, I'm still grateful that I had the opportunity to witness something of that demeanor to where it was awesome. Pastor Roosevelt came through there. And listen, then we did a mass choir. Listen, if y'all had to go back, listen, I ain't hollering at y'all, and I ain't pointing my finger at you. I'm just saying, I'm trying to give you words that would some give you a service. You didn't make service yesterday because I know a lot of services were churches were closed, but or they stream live, or you just didn't get a chance to get. If you seen all the other services, go back and watch this one. Okay, Let me help you with something. Hey, how are y'all guys? Say if I haven't read none of this. I got excited. Hey, Lynn. I got real excited. Listen, I am on my way to work. Listen, the church was set up on yesterday. Woo! Listen, y'all came through and we did this mass choir in churches that didn't even know the other church. When you got together and you sung like y'all been singing y'all entire life, look, the Lord was really, he was up. He's awesome. But when that service was going on yesterday, it was kind of like, good Lord, this is what we, you know, it wasn't I can't sing with y'all because I may not know that. It wasn't none of that. Everybody got together and sung. And I was like, listen, my little man had to go back and listen to it again last night. I was like, so you just going to sit here and we just going, okay, I just want to know. I had to find out. When I tell y'all, don't go back. Like I said, Pastor Roosevelt, we got up to do the offering and Bishop got up to do the offering and he passed it out to Pastor Johnson and then it was, I just can't talk about it. I can't even, it's hard for me to explain. Go back and look at it. If you wasn't there, go back and look at it. I promise you the awesomeness. Hey, how are you guys today? How you been? Listen, that mass choir. Woo! Well, listen, I don't even have words. It's like, what words do you have for the awesomeness that happened on yesterday? I'm about to turn this heat off. This ain't working. Turn that off because listen, it was so much fire. Look, you know, it ain't no F-I-R-E, fire, F-Y-E. It was so much fire in there. Look, you know, the older folks say fire. It was so much fire in there. It was ridiculous. Like, listen, the awesomeness, the greatness that happened on yesterday. If you weren't in the building, you probably, if you listen to it, if you don't just watch it, just listen, you'll think that we've been singing together. That was the first time we ever sung together as a whole. And it sounded like it was like, wait a minute, the roof is about to fall off, just blow off in this building. I'm telling y'all, go back and listen. Thank you, Pastor Johnson. Thank you to the new Gradom Mount Horeb Church. Sorry, I apologize. Thank y'all so much for coming through. It was great. It was awesome. I'm saying thank you from the bottom of my heart that is, because I appreciate y'all for that. And I know we're going to do something like that again because, woo, listen, I couldn't even. Listen, when the pastor can't even preach, when he can't even preach, you know that something is going on. I think my voice is going in and out. It's probably because all the hollering and singing and stuff that's been happening. That's probably what it is. Good morning. How are you guys today? Listen, those that are on the podcast, please go to our Facebook Live. We're on Facebook Live on God's Day. Please like, share, and follow the God's Day page. Please like, share, and follow the New Fremont Chapel Missionary Baptist Church page. Please like, share, and follow the Faith Fellowship of Churches page. All the pages have some great information on it that you need to know about. Some more things that are getting ready to happen. We will be with Pastor Johnson, Pastor Roosevelt Johnson, on April 4th at 7 o'clock, I believe. If it's not 7, it's 7:30, but y'all show up. If it's 7 o'clock, you're already there for 7:30. So we're going to be in service with them on Saturday, April 4th. At 7 o'clock. Oh, it's a lot going on April 4th. I just realized that. If they still allow us to have it. Oh no, they canceled they canceled the gigantic gospel concert. I was trying to go to that, but yeah, that's canceled. I seen that post the other day. But it's that's why I said it's a lot of stuff that they're canceling. Because of this Kono. Listen, we still had church. We didn't think about what happened after. I didn't even care. I was hugging folks and stuff. I don't care. Like, it is what it is. We got the, it's gonna be something that you may pass away from. So whatever, if it's for you, it's for you. If it's your time, it's your time. We can't be running scared. We don't survive so many other things. But my thing is, and I know Bishop said yes, because we've been having this conversation for the longest. It was a blessing to be in the building. Oh, yes, we will be doing it again. We are looking forward to seeing you all in April. Yes! I'm excited about April! I know that God is cleaning up. He probably, with something wrong, it is something wrong with me. I'm aware of my something wrongness. Hold on, y'all. Let me order me a sandwich real quick. Since I'm going to tell y'all about the work situation in just a second. Welcome to your hometown water for your mind, because I like smoking and customizing for anything. Yes, let me have, I just want the sandwich, a Whataburger Jr. with cheese.
Everything on it?
Yes, absolutely.
Whataburger Jr. with cheese, anything else?
Nope, that'll be all.
313, thank you.
Thank you. But listen, y'all better come on. I'm telling y'all, this awesomeness that we got with some great people. I told y'all, we be knowing some good folks that just love to have church. When I'm talking about church, know you are. No, it's just nothing in the middle. It's just CH and then CH. That's it. Nothing in the middle, because that's what it is. It's just awesomeness. It's just great. There's nothing in the middle. It's just CH and then you just see me just looking like, you like, wow, like, oh my gosh. And then it's a CH. That's what it is. That part, that's the part that's just like, whoo, listen. Okay, all right. Listen, we gonna talk about that sugar right now, because I do have a lot. I got a candy apple, I got banana pudding, I got some nothing bun cake, I got, what else did I have? I got the cake from yesterday too, the sheet cake that we had. I think I had a bag of candy, but I left that candy at the house. But everything else though, I'm just saying, I just can't stop talking about it because it was just, listen, I'm gonna do my best. Let me move on. Listen, okay, so this virus situation that's going on, like I said, it can be whatever it is. If it's what God's will for us to catch this and it to be what it is, I think it's just blown out of proportion. And I said, don't take it serious, but these are housekeeping rules that your family, your mama been telling you about when you was itty bitty, is to wash your hands. And wash your hands, not just go in there and run it under water. Wash it with soap and water. These are things your parents told you when you were little. It still means a lot when you're an adult. Like when you're grown, you're still supposed to wash your hands. You're still supposed to wash your hands. Oh, I do have some strawberries too. I forgot about that. I got some strawberries too. Listen, I'm just saying. But still do all of those things. Still take care of the precautionary measures. Still do that. But at the same time, do not be afraid to live your life and to still do the things that you know to be doing. This is something that we survived so many other things. Ebola, E. coli, Zika, West Nile, H1N1. We don't survive. Did the lights just go off up here? We don't survive so many different things that while we're letting this get blown out of proportion, it takes the focus off of the election. Nobody's really talking about the election right now. I told y'all about the white vans. Nobody's talking about any of this stuff right now. I will say, and I'm just guessing. No, I'm not going to say that. That will be wrong. I'm not going to say that. But I will say that a lot of things have gotten focused off of because of we've been focusing so much on this virus that has just taken over the country. And then they're talking about the martial law and doing all these other kind of things. That's why I said, I think my cousin, he was talking about, I said, you come to church tomorrow? This was Saturday. I don't know. I'm tired. Oh, well, me too. But I don't know if this is going to be my last time praising the Lord. I got the opportunity. Our churches is one of the churches that's going to be open tomorrow. You think I'm not going to go to church? I'm going. Whether I got to go with, I'm going. Because the church is a hospital. If it didn't, like I told him yesterday, I feel like this is, I told y'all a long time ago, if y'all can correct me, y'all can go to previous videos if you want to. I told y'all a long time ago that the Lord is trying to get our attention some type of way. I've been saying it for the longest. He's been trying to get our attention for the longest, and we have not been paying attention to what he's been trying to tell us to do all this time. We've been just overlooking it, keeping our focusing on other stuff. If it caused this to get our attention, sadly to say that somebody has to pass away or somebody has to get really sick or whatever, in order for us to pay attention to him. I've been saying it. He's been trying to get our attention for the longest. That's one thing. Another thing is we're afraid to live our life because we're afraid that we might catch this or whatever. You so scared to just touch and other stuff or whatever That's what's gonna, that stuff is gonna, my thing is this, don't run scared, don't be afraid, still live your life the way you've been living it. God's been trying to get our attention for the longest. He's been trying to tell us about all this stuff, this, and we lose focus. Don't stop going to church because of this situation. Like, I'm not talking about the ones that had to stream live. I'm not talking about those that had to make a decision like that. They're not the ones I'm talking about. I'm talking about those that your church is open and you trying to decide if you're going to go or not. That shouldn't be an option. They talking about you can catch this, and if you have a pre-existing condition, you can pretty much, it can be really, really bad for you. But you trying to, I guess, let me see, I'm tired. That's not an excuse to go. Now, if you're, like I said, if your church is, that's your member there, and they decided not to, they just going to do live stream. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about those that just, you want to go, but they won't let you come because of that. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about those that just decide, oh, I'm just too tired. What if God was tired? Because he's sick of you. He's sick of you doing the stuff you did. I said it. Yes, I did. He's sick of you. He's tired of you doing the same old stuff to him. You not praising him. You not worshiping him. You don't forgot about him. You don't let some man, some woman, some situation, your kids, your job interfere with God. And you can't put that ahead of him. Well, I got to go make my money. It's about my money. But if it wasn't for him to give you that talent or to give you that knowledge or to give you whatever it is for you to go on, what would you be doing? Would you have it? You wouldn't, because it's him that gave you that talent. It's him that gave you those skills. It was him that gave you that mindset to keep your job or to do whatever it is that your job is. He's giving you that mindset to do it. And because you in your feelings for whatever reason, or you feel like you've done this yourself, or God has not, Mary, God's day, how are you? Listen, August, don't forget August, you on for August. Okay, we ain't gonna talk about that today. We ain't gonna talk about that, but you do know that you're on for August. Anyway, God's day, listen, y'all know y'all got to hold on, let them scan my app real quick. Y'all know what I'm doing. I got to give me some. I'm great. How are you?
I'm pretty good. How about you?
I'm great.
It's going to be a Waterbury Junior. It's going to be 313.
Yes, let me scan. I want you to scan my app.
By any chance, can I get you to fill me those numbers? Sorry about that.
Sure. That's okay. It is 172 896-38. That's fine. I understand. Here you go. This is going to be my fifth time I get a free reward. Listen. So send me a text. Thank you. When I tell you I pulled up to this, to the drive-thru one day, and there was a guy, he been out here cleaning up, but I didn't know, he was behind a little wall right there. He's standing up there with some gloves on and a stick. Sir. Okay. I just looked at him. Hey, I had to make sure it was still him. You standing behind a wall with a broom, it was some gloves, with a stick and some gloves, but I think it's a broom or something. With some gloves on. I didn't know what was about to happen. I didn't know where you had went, sir. Let me make sure my burger is right. Don't judge me. I am eating a Whataburger Jr. with cheese. That is the plate for the day. We're eating that. But as I was saying, y'all, don't be afraid to still live your life and worship God. Don't make a decision on if you're gonna do it. What if God was so if he treat us like we treat him, how would that make you feel? That make you feel some type of way because you're just saying, Lord, you're gonna treat me like that because you're doing it to him. What if he was that type of God where he treated you the same way, where he had to make an excuse or make a decision or put other people ahead of you? And, or whatever, he had to do all those things in order for you to pay attention to him. You'll get a whole attitude. You'll be very upset because he decided that he's gonna help somebody else out, or he's gonna forget about. He don't do none of that. I love the type of God that he is. That he is just not that God that's gonna treat you like you treat him. And we'll be so messed up if that was a kind of, if that was it. And he's saying, I'm still going to show it to you, but I want you to know that I'm still God, that I am still here, that I am still the way, the truth, and the light. Okay? I am the way. So all this other stuff that's going on, that's happening, or you know, whatever, don't make a decision if I'm going to go serve God or not. Don't do that. I'm telling you the type of awesomeness that we had on yesterday. I can't stop talking about that because it was just awesomeness. Listen, I got up this morning. I was getting trying to get ready this morning. And I was like, I think my feet, my ankles, and everything is hurt. You know, you go to bed and then after everything, after your body just actually relaxed, it's like, good Lord. My whole entire body is just yeah, I'm paying for it today. But it's all good. I'll do it again because it's all about Him anyway. It's all about serving Him and worshiping Him. And I'm grateful to God how God has just been moving and doing these awesome things, these amazing things that He's been doing. I'm grateful for it. How He has just allowed us together here on every time we get together on here. I'm grateful for that because that means He woke you up too. And I'm excited about that. That's greatness. That means you're able to do things. You're able to do more today. You're able to do greater today. You're able to do, fix any problems, anything that you've done, anything that is done in your past, something you may have said to somebody or whatever. He has taken care of that. I mean, He has given you today. That's what I mean by taking care of. He's giving you today to give you the opportunity to fix those things. And it's just greatness. Just think about where you could be. This could be you at the hospital, because I think it's one of my Facebook friends. Her son has this virus and he's a child. So with him being a child, his immune system has to build up, and he's a young child, probably under 10 maybe, that has this. And she was saying, for y'all that think that this is a joke, it's not a joke. It's really serious. But you know, and it's only because of how it can do certain point. I'm not saying don't take this serious, but what I am saying is don't be so extra now that you want to wash your hands. You should have been doing it. Like, nobody have to. And I've been having this conversation with different people. Well, they have to put a sign up to tell you to wash your hands. They shouldn't have to tell you. Your mama told you that when you was a baby, when you was walking around, when you was a kid, when you became a teenager, when you became a grown person, they told you the same thing. Wash your hands. Don't come out the restroom until you, because you don't know what you touch. You don't know what kind of thing. And you're bringing it back to wherever you're going. Wash your hands. They've been telling you this stuff. Don't act like it's just this far. Where when they have to put a sign up, you just like, you should not tell grown people to do that. They should know. They should have to read no sign to know they supposed to be washing their hands. If you do have some that just walk out, they don't even care. But you're not even thinking about the other people around you. You don't want to wash your hands. Wash your hands for me. You ain't got the way. If you don't want to wash them for you, you wash them for me. Because you don't know what somebody, you don't know what you got. You're not walking around with this radar that tell you, oh, I got this or I got that. No, you don't have none of that. You ain't got none of that. So, wash your hands. Do what you're supposed to be doing to keep everything clean, keeping yourself clean, keeping your family together. So this virus, because we will pass. This too shall pass. We're going to overcome this. We're going to pass. This is going to go over. Like everything else that we have survived, we have been through. And I just, because I even asked the young people at church last night or yesterday morning, I said, what happened to that? I said, all this stuff, I said, we don't hear about the West Nile virus no more. We don't hear about the H1N1, whatever it is. We don't hear about that no more. And these are mosquitoes that's supposed to have been carrying this. When was the last time you heard about the West Nile virus? That was a few years ago. I said, what happened to chickenpox? I said, y'all don't even know anything about chickenpox. We went through that. They not even talking. Where was chickenpox at now? When was the last time you heard of somebody having chickenpox? Like, you don't hear nobody having chicken. You don't hear nobody having chickenpox no more. What happened to that? It just went out of thin air. Just like, because when I told them about chickenpox, they were looking at me like, no, we didn't. I said, exactly. Y'all have no idea what that's about. Y'all didn't experience, y'all didn't go through that part, to where you had to go through that little itching with your calamine lotion and going on. You didn't have to do none of that. But all this stuff, that's what I'm saying. We've overcame so many different things this is not going to be it. Oh, I got a new reward. Yay, they just texted me. They sent me a notification. But you got the, we don't overcame so many other things. You're going to overcome this. This is not going to be the last thing. This won't be the last situation that's going on. You won't, you know, but things like this happen for a reason. But again, as I've been stating long time ago, that the Lord's been trying to get our attention for how long? For so long. And if it have to take something of this demeanor in order for him to get our attention, it have to do it. We just have to be, have to do that. That it is what it is. But y'all know how to tell y'all about people that are doing some amazing things, some awesomeness, including myself. All right. So I have a couple of things that I have to say about what I got going on. First thing is, this Saturday, if everything still works out, I will be on The Fragrant Lady with ladies, Tamara Kelly. And we will be doing the First Lady broadcast or whatever. It'll be this Saturday at 9 o'clock. If everything goes well, it'll still be this Saturday. If nothing changes, this is so far. I'm just saying as of today, that's still what it is. The First Lady's segment broadcast with The Fragrant Lady, Lady Tamara Kelly. And then on April 18th at 11 o'clock, I will be one of the speakers, seven of the speakers for the New Mount Zion Baptist Missionary Baptist Church of Dallas. I do not have the pastor's name. I don't have all of that, but it's at 11 o'clock and I don't have the address. So once I get all of that, I will let you know. But I wanted you to put it on your calendar. If you want to attend that, it's on April 18th. At 11 a.m. So, I believe I'm right. I believe it's 11. I got it wrote down on my desk. But that will be on April 18th. So, if you're able to make it, if you're able to come and support. I'm not sure of anybody else that's on there. I don't know of anybody else that's on there because she hasn't told me. So, I'm just letting you know that I'll be speaking there for their 7-Up program. And that is that. Now, I am an ambassador for two different fashion lines, I guess, designers, I guess. So if y'all see me posting about one, the other one I probably post about here really probably this week. I have to find out. But the other one I've already been posting about, I have to wait for the products to come in. But I'm excited about that. Yay! So I posted about it and it's called U-Test. Maybe Utah's, but it is a online boutique store, and I would be one of their ambassadors for their clothing. So if you see me posting about it, go on there and look. You might not, if it's something you can't use, you might have somebody that you know that can use the stuff that's on there. They don't just sell clothes. It is women clothing or a women's boutique, but it may be something on there that you might find really cute or you might want. But you can use my promo code that is on there. And like I said, it's two different ones. So I'm going to have to write it down so I can remember the promo code to tell you about this one. But this one is the Utah's. And they might call it UTAS. I don't know if it's TAS or TOS, whichever one. But the link is on there. Click on the link. Use my, if you purchase something, use my promo code. And you can get a discount. And I believe it's 40% off. I do have another one. And that one is 25% off. I will, once I get all the information going for that one, I will post about that too. And you have two different places so far to shop and get some good deals and get some nice things, some really nice things. So once my packages come in, I will post about it and let y'all know what I got and tag or whatever. But if you want to, please go on there. Like I said, I've attached the website on there. So please go on there. And once I get the second ambassador information to post, I will post about it and let you know about that particular company as well. So that's two other things that I'm adding on to my already major list of things going on. So that will be something that you can look into. And like I said, if it's not for you, maybe somebody that you know, maybe family or friends, you know, birthdays is still coming. You have anniversaries that are still coming. You just want to give somebody a nice gift. You can go on there and they have a lot of good things. Like I said before, a lot of great things that are on there. So please check them out. So, as I post it, click on it, go forward. I've also created a Linktree website to where you can go on there and click on any one of them, follow on the, on there you can click on the links and it'll show you all of the social medias that I'm attached to. From the podcast information all the way to all the social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, all those all that information is there. So if you go on there, on my Instagram page, it's on the Instagram page, and it's also on the Guys Day page, and also on my page. So you go to Unquenic, AUNQUNIC, and that is on there. The links are there for that, and also the post and the links is there for the for me being a new ambassador for this company. So please don't forget to go out there and do that. Go to the Guys Day page if you have not already. Like, share, and follow that page. If you have not went to go follow the New Freeman Chapel Missionary Baptist Church page, please go and like that page as well. Also, don't forget to like the family, the faith family, the faith fellowship of churches. He's going to jump on me. The faith fellowship of churches. Please go on there and like, share, and follow that page too. There's new information that's going to be coming up. And you don't want to miss out. If you're already liking the page, you will see what's happening. I am excited about what God is doing with this fellowship. He's going to change some things around. He's going to make it awesome, more awesome than he did in 2019. It's going to be more awesome in 2020. Because he's just that type of guy. We are trusting and believing he's going to do these amazing things. He's just going to be wonderful. It's just going to be wonderful. So anyway, please like it, share, and follow those pages. Also, y'all already know. So please go and follow Miss Tracy Green with Voluptuous Woman of Pearl. Voluptuous Woman of Pearl. Hey, how are you guys saying? Voluptuous Woman of Pearl has everything you need. VWA has everything you need from the top of your head to the sole of your feet. She has everything you need. If you go to her page, Tracy Green, I'm calling Miss Tracy. She went live last night and she has a lot of great products that are on there. I shall be receiving a package today. She went live Friday. And she mailed it off Saturday, so probably by the time I get home today, it should be at the house. I'm excited about it. I told y'all she's like Amazon without you being an Amazon Prime member. She don't think so, but I believe so. When you ship the way that you ship, I don't order some stuff from Amazon just this past week. Guess when I'm going to get it? Wednesday or Thursday. And I ordered it like Thursday or maybe Friday. I think I ordered it Thursday. But I won't get it until like Wednesday or Thursday. And they Amazon. So she's better than Amazon. Okay, I'm just saying. Excuse me. Maybe because of all this stuff that's happening, they got a lot of deliveries or whatever, because I know I don't have to wait that long. Hey, lady, how are you guys today? So please go and follow Miss Tracy Green with Voluptuous Woman of Pearl. Again, she has everything you need from the top of your head to the sole of your feet. She's like an Amazon. She's like Amazon without you being an Amazon Prime member. So check her out. Also, check out Tianda Smith with Star Diva Bling with T. Star Diva Bling with T is a paparazzi consultant. She has a lot of great things, a lot of great jewelry that you need. With her being a paparazzi consultant, you can check her out. Her daughter is also one with C-E-E Bling. My bad. C-Bling has, she's a paparazzi consultant. She's following her mother's footsteps. So please support these beautiful young ladies. Follow their page, C-Bling. And Star Diva Bling with T. And she has Star Diva Bling with T VIP. The VIP has a little different situation going on. But it is amazing. So please check out Tianda Smith and Sierra Smith. And also check out Emerion Smith. I know a lot of people live with this. I know. Emerion Smith with the Duck Off. The Duck Off is a place you can go and relax. Get your mind right. Get your life in order. Get your thoughts and stuff. Did they close them down? Or maybe I'm just... Oh, I missed the sign. Thought they closed down this store over here by me. I was like, wait. What's her name? Emerion Smith. Sorry, y'all. With the Duck Off. It's a place you can go and relax, get your mind right, meditate, pray, get your life in order. Just forget about everything else that's going on around you. And you can still get, you know, have a great time. She also does bounce houses for grown folks, for kids, for everybody. That you can rent cotton candy machines and other stuff that she has. So please check her out. And she also has Cheryl's Kit Kat pickles. That's the Kool-Aid pickles. Those pickles that you can, those sweet, you have that sweet tooth. She's also in convenience stores. If you go to her page, Cheryl's Kit Kat pickles, S-H-R-E-L, apostrophe S, Kit Kat pickles, you will see her, You will see all the flavors that she has. You will see the local stores that she's in. She's in a lot of different local stores. Hey, cousin, how are you guys? Hey. She's in a lot of different local stores within the Oak Cliff area that I know of. She may be in more. But if whatever, please go like, share, and follow her. That's Sherelle's Kick A Pickles, SHREL'S, and it's Kick A Pickles, okay? And she said if it doesn't have her signature cut or her signature seasoning, it is not hers. So please support her with that. And the duck off, she also has the duck off. And her number is 214-309-0799. Hold on, I'm gonna tell y'all. Y'all about it, Marion Smith. That ain't the one I had right the first time. So, and Marion Smith was with Sherelle's Kick A Pickles. She has different variety of flavors in the duck off. Bounce houses with boxing gloves, six basketball goals, campers, cotton candy machines, rentals, and more. You can contact her. I had it right the first time. 214-309-8799. Again, her number is 214-309-8799. She is with Sherelle's Kick A Pickles in the duck off. So please like, share, and follow her. Also, please like, share, and follow Michelle Ivy with Ivy Credit Repair. Excuse me. Ivy Credit Repair has everything you need. When it comes down to your credit repair, it comes down to taxes, legal documents, and she does much more. You go to her website, which is ivycreditrepair.com, for all the services that you need. You can use my promo code, credit05A is in Apple 81. Again, it's credit05A is in Apple 81. And like I said, she does credit repair, taxes, legal documents, notary, and a whole lot more. And she has, you can do it virtually. You don't have to be in her presence in order to get the things done that you need. But you can also talk to her. 469-765-7732. Again, Michelle Ivy with Ivy Credit Repair at 469-765-7732. So please check her out. And use my promo code, credit05, A is in Apple, 81. Also, she has an online jewelry store, which is ivybeautytreasures.com. ivybeautytreasures.com is Michelle's Ivy online jewelry store. Also, check out Awana Braxton Morgan with Heavily Anointed Jewels for $5. She is another paparazzi consultant that I've been knowing for years. So please like, share, and follow her page as well. And please support her when she go live. If you're already on her page, you will get that same information. Cousin, I was telling them about that I'm an ambassador for two different fashion boutiques, I guess you can say. One of them I already posted about. The other one I have to hold off before I can post about it. But once I get the information, I'll post it and let y'all know about it. But this one is the U-Test. And I posted the information this weekend. And that is for you all to go on there. I know it's a lot of shopping that's going on, but we love cute stuff. We love pretty things. And we love awesome things, and we love to support each other and whatever is going on. So I'm adding this on to something I'm already doing. So I'm an ambassador for this company called UTAS, and what they are is a online boutique store. It might be some things on there that you can have. You can give as buy and give as a gift. Use a promo code that's on there. It's attached to it. Once you click on that link, you add my promo code on there, and when you check out, and you will be able to get some awesome things at a really good price. And once my packages come in, I'm gonna tell you something, show you what I purchased from them. I'm gonna wear it and post it and let y'all know how something that I've got from them. And also, it's with a different company, but once I get the other company everything up and running with that one, I'm gonna let you know about that one. So it's two different ones so far. I do have some other stuff going on, but this is where I'm just doing one thing at a time right now. These two I've started up with. So, I'm just letting you all know about this. So, if you see, hey, how are you guys today? So, if you see me posting about this online boutique store, it is not my store. I'm just an ambassador for their store. And with me being an ambassador for it, I'm just letting you know y'all can get a discount with this store, this online boutique store. You are able to get a discount when you use my promo code for finding you some pretty things for your daughters, for your nieces, for your cousins, for your mama, for yourself. You made it. And it's not just clothing, it's other stuff that they have on there. But please support if you can and will. Just check out the website. It's on my page. Again, go like the God's Day page. God's Day Whispers in the Pews. Please like, share, and follow that page. I add everything that I try to see, whatever is going on within the community. Community awareness, birthdays, anniversaries, all those other things I try to share so everybody can see what's going on. And so he just walked in the job with a whole monitor. Okay. gonna be out. So if you see all these things that I'm posting about, if I post about it, it means I'm recommending it. Also, I've told y'all about my link that has all my social media platforms, so you won't have to click on each one. You'll have one spot and you can click on it. It's gonna take you directly to it because the link is already there. So if you see that Linktree website or link, you already know. Once you click that link, it's going to pop up with all my social media things. And you'll be like, okay, well, she's on this, she's on that. You can find me on social media, on Facebook, on Instagram, on podcast. For those that don't know about the podcast, we do now have a podcast that's been running for about 3-4 weeks now. Please go out there and like, share, and follow the podcast. If you miss previous episodes, you don't want to go back and find all the Facebook Lives that we've ever talked about, or I won't say ever, because the podcast has only been around for about 4 weeks now. So if you want to go back and listen to previous episodes, go on there. Go to the link for the podcast. It's on my God's Day page. If you click on that Linktree post, it's going to pop up. You got Apple Podcasts. You click on that Apple Podcast link, it's going to take you straight there. You're going to automatically be attached to the God's Day information. Click on that, download the episodes in your free time when you're offline or you can't be on social media or whatever. You can still listen in. And it's all on all types of platforms. Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spreaker, Deezer, CastBox, Podcast Addict, Podchaser, Spotify, iHeartRadio. So if you see any of those, please like, share, and follow those. I would really appreciate it if y'all can definitely do that for me. Please don't forget to like any of the pages I said, the New Freeman Chapel Missionary Baptist Church page, the Faith Fellowship of Churches page, and the God's Day page. Please like, share, and follow all of these pages. Oh, I did forget to tell y'all about my beautiful niece. She has an online boutique store, Tekasha Brown Olale. That is one of my nieces. Please like, share, and follow her. She models her own stuff, and I promise you, you're going to be like, wow, she has some. She is great. So please like her, like, share, and follow her page. She's also on Instagram. You're a person that go to Instagram a lot. You can go on there, Fortress Boutique. FortressBoutique.BigCartel.com. FortressBoutique.BigCartel.com. Please like, share, and follow that information. Follow her page. Like, go to her website. See the information that she has and support her as well. She's doing some awesomeness. Y'all know I have to go, but I want y'all to be awesome today. Don't let this coronavirus stop you from being the great person that you are. Don't be so scared to live your life and to do things that you are supposed to. Still take precautionary measures. Still do it. Wash your hands and take care of all these other things, these housekeeping rules. Please make sure that you're doing those things and tell others to do the same thing. No. Come here. Wash your hands. We're washing our hands. Sing the happy birthday song twice to make sure that your hands is all clean and all done up. Make sure that you are just continue to be that great person. Don't let nobody change your character. Don't let nobody change you. Don't let nobody change anything about you. Do you for you. Make sure it's in God's will. Make sure you're doing things according to Him. God is an awesome God. He's seen, and I told y'all this stuff that's going around. He's been trying to get our attention. This is His way of getting our attention. So this is our faith being tested. He's testing our faith to see if we're strong enough to stand the test of this is what's going on in this world. Then it is what it is. I've been saying it for the longest that something is going on to where he's going to get our attention. And it's if your faith is strong. That's why I said the people that are Christians, that say they're Christians, they say they love the Lord. This is your test to see if you really love the Lord. Let's see if you really are a believer. You still believe if you still have the faith the size of a mustard seed. You already know who can take care of you, who's covering you, who's protecting you, who's making sure that you're good. He's making sure that you are awesome. He's making sure that you're still here. But what are you going to do? You're going to run. You're going to tuck your tail and you're going to be run scared. Or you're going to stand up and you're going to say, I'm fighting this. We're going to get through this. I'm going to have the faith. My family is not going to get this. My family won't suffer from this. I won't suffer from this. Or you're going to sit there and say, oh my gosh, I don't know what to do. They're saying they got over here. They're doing this over here, and you're so afraid because of the news and because of the media. They have blown this out of proportion, like, for real. So my job, I was intending to tell y'all about that before I go in here. My job has decided they're going to send everybody home. Hey, lady, how are you guys? Hey, they're going to send everybody home or whatever. So we're supposed to make sure everybody's up and running. Hey, how are you guys? Hey, if everybody's up and running and doing what they're supposed to do, guess what? They're going to send everybody home. If your computer is good to go, you go home and it is what it is until they tell you to come back. Because my job is over that limit of people. My job is over the limit of people. So they're going to push us out of here because of the CDC has said that over whatever. We over the limit if it's over 30. If we over 500, we over the limit, okay? Our limit is, yeah, the parking lot is looking kind of scary. Side here is looking a little bitty. But I know we have to come in and just get, find out what's going on and get on, find out what we have to do. So I should be working from home probably one day this week. If not today, maybe tomorrow. They're supposed to be getting us up and running and getting us going. So anyway, but I'm not afraid to just live my life and run. I'm not going to do that because now this is my faith being tested to see if I really believe that God can. He told us to fear not. Like, why are we fearing? What are we fearing for? You're not supposed to fear. As I stated earlier, we have overcame the E. coli, the Ebola, the N1, H1N1, whatever, West Nile. We don't overcame all this stuff. I was saying earlier, where's the chicken pox? These kids don't know nothing about chicken pox. They know about a cold and a sneeze and a cough, but they don't know nothing about chicken pox. Where's chicken pox? When did they stop making chicken pox possible? Who took it away? Like, I didn't even know you could take it away. Like, y'all just up and just got rid of chicken pox? Like, I didn't even know that was a... Okay. I'm just asking. Wow. Yeah, they pretty much sent us home. If they had got everything up and running Friday, I wouldn't have came today. I would have been already at home. So those that already have a laptop, they didn't have to come today. But if you don't have a laptop, you have to come. So I'm here because I don't have a laptop. So they're supposed to get everybody up to work from home. And they was asking questions to make sure everybody can work from home. You're able to do it. So they're trying to do that because they're trying to condense, because we're over that required, that limit. We're over it, like, big time. My job is, so they have to take the project. I understand that, but at the same time, I'm not fearing, because I already know God is covering me. He's covering my family. He's covering you. And that's my belief. And for those that cannot work, I pray that they find a way that they can, still compensate you for being off. This is not your fault. So they should find a way that you need to still get paid, because this has nothing to do with you. It ain't like you called in and say, oh, I'm not coming. No, you told me I can't come. Like, that's on you because of whatever is going on. So y'all need to find a way to do it. I think a lot of people they're just not prepared for this. I've said something, I didn't know what it was going to be, that is going to cause us to go through some things and our faith being tested. God trying to show us some things. He's been trying to get our attention for how long? We done went through and I'm not saying it's over, but the white vans or the vans that's kidnapping and picking up people and all that, but you can go on and do it if you want to. I will cough all on, listen, I ain't got it, but I will sneeze, I'll create a sneeze and I'll sneeze, I'll snatch me if you want to. You'll be sitting up there saying, I'm going to say it, I got it. Lord, please forgive me because I don't want it, but I'm just saying, if you snatch it, I'm going to create a sneeze. I don't even know, and it's going to be very, 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 very much like rain when I get through. I'm going to leave that alone. I'm just saying, that way you won't be trying to take nobody else. Try it again. You won't be trying to take nobody else. I don't think you want to take nobody. You don't know who got what. Okay. Y'all sitting up here taking people and you don't know what's going on. I'm just saying, I'm going to leave it alone. But let's just be careful. Still watch ourselves, watch our children, watch our belongings, watch how this world is going, the rate that it's going at. Stay prayed up. Keep praying. Don't give up on life. Don't give up on you. Don't give up on God. Definitely don't give up on God. Don't stop serving God. Don't stop worshiping Him. Don't stop giving Him the praise. Don't stop being that, you know, being that awesome person I keep telling y'all, because we're awesome. We're beautiful. We're pretty. We're handsome. We got some great things going for us, and we can't let the world, what's going on in the world, change us. We can't let the things that are going on in our, and that's going to change our lives in a blink of an eye, We can't let that stuff change us. We are some great people. God got some awesome work for us to do. And maybe this is for us to get this break, is to get focused more on Him. To take this time away to get focused more on Him. To get some things that we've been overlooking for a while. This is our opportunity. Maybe cause us to come together and see how much we can be a family. No more bickering, no more arguing, no more of that. Let's just see how we can get along and being confined into the house for a couple of weeks or whatever. I told my kids that, they was like, no, we can't. I said, if they do this mortal law, you ain't going to have a choice. You can't go outside. You can't do out. You can't roam the streets. They going to make you stay in. You can't do that. They don't think that that's true. I said, all right, it's possible. It is definitely possible that they can do that. So, okay. I guess he wanted her to get what he needed and came on now. First of all, before I take this bag in here, thank you, Lynn. I got my candy apple. You know what? I don't think I'm going to take nothing in here, because let me see what's going on. They might just tell me, ma'am, down to get on out of here. We was waiting on you to come in so you can get on out. Guess what? I'm going to oblige you. But I ain't had to get up and, you know, bump my hair a little bit and put on some clothes and look like somebody today. Y'all could have called me and told me, you ain't got to make me drive out of here wasting my little old gas. I got a full tank, but I'm just saying. Waste of my gas. I think I'm gonna leave my bag until if I have to come get it, I'll come get it. But I wanted to be sure. Okay, I think I'm gonna leave that. I just don't want to carry a lot and then they turn around and tell me, ma'am, grab that and go get out of here. So I want to be sure that we got everything going this morning. Hold on a second. Make sure we have everything going this morning to where I'm trying to make sure we have everything going this morning to where if we have to leave here, that I'm prepared or whatever, because we never know what this situation may take us, and if I need anything else out here, I just have to come back. But just making sure that we're doing that. But yeah, stay encouraged. Don't let this stuff stop you from living your life. Don't let this stop you from doing things that you're supposed to be doing. And let's just keep our focus on who we're supposed to be keeping our focus on. Let's keep our focus on things that are supposed to be, that we're supposed to give attention to. Again, like I stated before, there's a lot of stuff that's going on, that's happening, and we just want to make sure that we don't miss God or anything else when it comes down to all this stuff that's happening. I was saying earlier that I am now an ambassador for two different fashion boutique online stores. So if you see me posting about those links, please go on there and see if you can find you something on there. There's my promo code. Sorry, the phone is shaking. There's my promo code that's on there. Use that promo code and just shop away. If you can't do it now, maybe later on in the future you possibly can. But I do want y'all to know that I am now an ambassador for two different fashion boutique online boutique stores. One I've already posted about, the other one I have to wait. But once I get the confirmation to post, I will post that information so y'all can see that, and then also the things that I received from them to show y'all what beautiful items that I got, and I will tag who I got it from and all that other kind of good stuff. So if you see me posting about it, just click on there. You might want to shop. Find you a few things on there for you, your child, a family member of yours. You can do that. I would love for you too. But one of them is Utas. So if you see it on there, click on that link. Like, share. It's through
I put the link, it's through Instagram, but I put the link on my other pages too, so y'all can see. That they have on their page. So go on there and shop away. Use my promo code. Once I get the other ones up and running, like I should, I will let you all know. Good morning. How y'all doing? You can see all of the good things that are on there. So check that out. I will tag it on this post too. When I do, y'all know how I tag everybody on here. Also, I forgot to check out my sister-in-law, Lakeisha Norman Brown, with Curl Word. It's an online boutique. She makes her own natural hair product. So if you see me posting about Lakeisha Brown Norman, you already know who that's about. Like, share and follow her too.
G to the H.
Then I'm going to get out of here because I need to find out what's going on so I can hear up and come home if this is what need be, or maybe work all day and don't come tomorrow. I don't know what's happening. So I need to find all of that out. But I'm going to tag all these people on this video. I'm going to let y'all know who to follow and to add. If y'all have some people that need to be followed or they doing some great things I don't know about, let me know. They got a page, a business page, or their own page, but they're selling something, they have an event, they got some stuff going on, whatever it is. Don't forget about the podcast. I'm going to share that link too. Click on that podcast link. When you click on the link, it's going to show you everything. You can download whatever episodes, all the episodes. I believe there's 20... It might be 20 or 21 episodes. I'm not sure how many it is. It's 20-something. But we're going to add today. And today's is going to be on there, too. So go to the podcast. Please like, share, and follow. You want to be a guest on the podcast? Go to guysday81@gmail.com and email me and let me know you want to be a guest. So if you have my number, you don't have to. We don't have to meet up or anything. We can do it over the phone. So just to let you know that I've been working on some stuff. Y'all be excited about the stuff I've been working on. So just to let you know that. So don't forget about any of these things. Remember to continue to be that awesome person that you are. Continue to know that God loves you. Continue to know that God is watching you. He's still listening to your prayers. Continue to know that he's everything that you need. Nobody is above him. No one can take his place. He's sovereign. He can do whatever he wants to whenever he gets ready. He's our all in all. He's wonderful. He's amazing. Get to know him if you don't know who he is. All the stuff that's happening around the world, this will make you need this. You should need to get closer to God because of that. He's just so great. I love him for who he is. I love him for the awesome person that he has made all of us to become. But keep looking forward. Keep on trusting God. Keep on believing. Keep on. Don't let this world stop you from being that awesome person and to live your life. This is not the end. It's not a period. It's a comma. Just a little pause here for a second, and we're going to continue on with life afterwards. Remember, God loves you. I love you. And there's nothing you can do about it. I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.